What the? Hey, scientists, what's going on? Why was that happening?
Wow, that was weird, right? So, I'm Dr. Perry, and I'm here to help you feel a little less stuck at home and explain what was going on in that weird activity. This week, we're exploring the Creative World Gallery, which is all about helping you build things to make your world a little bit better. And today, we're building something with a balloon. Oh, there it is. And a can. All right, so got our can, and I got a stack of books here so you can see the can a little bit better. What you want to do is make sure the can is stable, it's not moving. Then you want to take that balloon, and we need to put some charge on it. So rub it against your head. We've all got a little bit longer hair these days because we're stuck at home. I haven't had a haircut in probably like 2 months. You can see it's kind of like making my hair go a little crazy because it's pulled these things called electrons and they've moved between my hair and the balloon. But I haven't been rubbing the can against anything, so it doesn't have any charge. But when I put it next to the balloon, it wants to roll off the off the table, off the books. Here, I'll show you again in case you missed it. So we're rubbing balloon on our hair. And this has a negative charge from these tiny little things called electrons that make up part of the atoms that make up everything in our world. Now it's supercharged, so the can's rolling a lot faster now. So there's actually something kind of similar going on here that's going on in a real thing you might have at home or maybe your parents have in their office. A copy machine or certain kind of printers like laser printers also have a roller like this that gets charged up with electricity and it pulls ink out of a cartridge, and then when paper rolls by the roller, that ink transfers from the roller to the paper, and then you get your printout. Of what you were trying to print from your printer. So like that's kind of cool. And like when you understand how to move electrons around and how to control static electricity, you can build things not just like printers or copiers, but you can make batteries because you can put electricity in one place and store it there so that like your phone, your laptop doesn't die and the batteries can be longer lasting. Or you can even build things like electric cars or solar cars, because you're able to control where electricity is moving and how to store it so that you can make a car that runs on electricity instead of having to put gas in it. And these are all examples of things that you can learn about and see in Creative World. So where are some other places you might have seen static electricity? Well, if you've done laundry lately, you might notice that your clothes are kind of sticking to each other after you pull them out of the dryer. Well, that happens basically because of the same reason the balloon makes my hair stand up when I rub the balloon against my hair. You got all your clothes kind of rubbing against each other, you know, making all of this charge and electrons move from your shirt to your sock and from your sock to your shirt. And when you pull them out, they might be all stuck together. And one way that I like to prevent that at home, and maybe you do this too, is you have these things like dryer sheets. And so you can take one of these sheets out and put it in your laundry. And these things will help soak up all those electric charges so they don't get stuck between all your clothes rubbing together and then your socks aren't stuck to your shirts anymore. All right, so back to this can and the balloon. So when we put the balloon that we rubbed against our head next to the can, we can predict what happens, you know, based on what we saw earlier. The can is gonna wanna roll towards the balloon because they have electrons that like want to attract or repel each other. But sometimes in our world, you know, it's not as simple as a balloon and the can example. There's other things we know are going to happen, like earthquakes, but we can't exactly predict when they're going to happen. We're getting better, but we've still got some more to learn. But we do know enough about earthquakes to build buildings that are more resilient against them. Because, I mean, come on, we live in SoCal, we live in Los Angeles, a lot of us. We know an earthquake's going to come, so we want to be prepared. And based on what we know about how the ground shakes, and how materials bend when the ground shakes, we can make buildings that can withstand earthquakes better now than they did in the past. So those are just some examples of things that you can build better to improve the world around you. Now I hope you go and find a can and a balloon at home and you build your own things and see what else crazy, what other kind of crazy things you can build with these rollers. So that's it for me. Hope you feel a little less stuck at home now and see you later. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Bye.
Be sure to visit our website Monday through Friday at 10 a.m. for more stuck-at-home science activities.